most of the cast and the crew were brought on before I was.
And by crew, you mean the real crew or the fake crew?
Crew.
Crew. Got you. Okay.
Cast crew.
Cast crew.
The cast crew. Crew cast.
Gosh, that's gotta be so confusing.
A little bit.
Okay.
Just a little bit. Only sometimes. So the cast, who is plays the crew.
Sure.
Most of them were brought on before I was actually brought onto the project.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Michael had a very good idea of who he wanted, and he generally just, as this was being conceptualized, just was like, I like this person, I like this person, I like this person for this. And then once he had it kind of fleshed out in his mind, he was able to pull who he wanted onto the project.
Cool. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And so then tell me where you got involved.
I got involved earlier, at the beginning of the year. And there was a scene where, in the film, the director, fake director, in the film, basically talks about how, oh, well, we might need a few more actors. And the other guys are like, oh, are you kidding me? Mm-hmm. Are you kidding me? I don't want to go through this audition process ever again. And so what we needed to do for that is then it would cut to a flashback, and they would be a bunch of clips next to each other of them going through auditions and having to audition all of these awful actors and good actors and just, you know, like, it's an audition process. And so I got involved right there where I had to cast actors for an audition that was going to be an audition in the film. Which was confusing trying to, like, communicate that with the actors, because they're like, well, when do I know if I got in? And I'm like, no, you're in. Like, that's going to be a part of the film. You're going to be credited as yourself. And they're like, but no, when do I get in? So we had some really great actors. And
Yeah.
Olia Klein, I think, she came in with her son, Jaden, who's actually shooting Sinister and Sinister 2. He just got done with Sinister 2 right now. She came in and she pretended to be a very overbearing stage mom, and we had Harold Dennis come in and give like a terrifying rendition of like a very good monologue.
Nice.
He's a great actor.
Nice.
And just various other people that we could find.
Wait, I'm sorry, did you want me to change my dialogue?
I'm gonna get that gun, then I'm gonna get that money.
James Clifton.
Caitlin Coleman.
Samantha Miller.
Sean Rogers.
Hi, my name is Mia Klein and I'm 12 years old.
Hi, my name is Jane.
Guys, you ready? Okay. Please just smile, concentrate. This kid's amazing, I have to tell you.
Harold Dennis, when he came into the room, he's a very charismatic man.
Yeah, yeah.
And very happy and excited, and you're instantly like energetic. It's like, because he brings so much energy to the table, it's like you have extra energy all around the room.
Yeah, yeah.
And so when he turned from, like, he did a monologue of a cop, I think, a dirty cop.
Okay.
Asking for money from a dude he was extorting. And he scared the living daylights out of me because he's this nice, kind man, and I had never met him before, and then he just started yelling.
Oh.
And I honestly had like a mini heart attack, and I had to try really hard not to show it. And Michael's like, are you okay? Like, are you going to be okay? Do you need a moment? And I was like, no, I'm good. Let's keep going. I'll be fine. And we held it in like, we held it in the Harold Washington Library because we thought it would look really nondescript and kind of like boring and blasé.
Sure, they're just white walls in those rooms.
Yeah, generally when you're doing casting, you want like a blue wall behind them and you want to use like, you generally don't need an HD camera. You use your cell phone.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, because then you can send it to a director immediately or,
right,
you know, because they want it instantly generally. But for here, we sent, you know, we shot it on the camera.
Yeah.
So it was, and he would heckle the actors too. He would have them do a monologue. Michael would be there. And he would be there and we would be off screen. And he would heckle the actors after they had performed their monologue and he would warn them first. But it was just, he would just shoot the shit with them. It was hilarious. And there were some people who were just kind of like iffy and didn't know what to do. And some people just ran with it and it was gorgeous.
You're just taking mental notes. Like,
oh God, just, oh my God, I love this.
Build.
You have no idea. Like, the impression that people make when they come into a casting, if you do well, and the thing is that like, we want you to be a solution to the problem when you walk into the door, like we're just like, please, I want you to be in this movie.
Yeah.
But yeah, if you make an impression, even if you don't get the part, like the name sticks out somehow.
Hmm.
Like, you know how when you meet people at a party and you're just like, I don't know you.
But that you're cool.
Yeah. But then you have their resume and that kind of gets, what's the word? Imprinted into your mind, their face with their name under it.
Mm, yeah, sure.
So, yeah.
Did resumes on paper, did that kind of frequently coincide with what you saw on camera, what you saw come into the room? Or were they
talent levels?
Yeah, yeah.
Well, sometimes. Sometimes we would get actresses who, we had one actress who was 17, mm-hmm. and she had little to no experience because she's young, but she was great. She's cool. Fantastic. And then we had people who had like Second City classes and sure. theater and like, you know, everybody's been on the Great Chicago Fire.
Yeah.
But I mean, but it's you know, people
almost.
Who have been on
I
like,
still haven't been, so if you need people. Okay.
Yeah. Neither have I.
Right.
For future reference.
She still hasn't been. So
Putting it out there.
Great.
Yeah. But yeah, it's generally just kind of, you can tell by how their resume is set up.
Yeah.
If it's printed on printer paper, I'm generally less impressed, unless it has a great format.
Oh, interesting. Okay.
Like if they print their photo on printer paper.
Oh, I see what yeah. you're saying. I see what, I
That's like, an issue. I'm not a fan of that because if I spill something on it and stuff gets spilled a lot.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Absolutely.
Like coffee, water.
Yeah.
Tears.
Yeah.
You
other
know,
people's.
Could, yeah, other people's, for sure. It's not me. But yeah, it can ruin the paperwork and yeah. I can lose the picture instead of just having it be warped. A resume can always be recovered, but you know, the picture is always great to have on file
absolutely.
To look back on for future reference.
Yeah.